I'm Dr. Kevin Thomas, a cardiac electrophysiologist with the Norton Heart and Vascular Institute. The heart's electrical system produces signals that control the timing of your heartbeats. Sometimes, this system can beat irregularly and cause symptoms of palpitations, rapid heartbeats, or skipped heartbeats. This can be due to short circuits in the electrical system, extra heartbeats, or abnormal electrical connections. These abnormal rhythms are called arrhythmias. Oftentimes, these are not dangerous, but they can become serious when they affect the heart's ability to pump blood or if they are due to another underlying heart condition. Treatment of arrhythmias may include medications or a procedure called catheter ablation. A catheter ablation is a minimally invasive procedure to correct an arrhythmia. Catheter ablation can be performed to diagnose and treat a wide variety of arrhythmias, including supraventricular tachycardia, also known as SVT, atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter, ventricular tachycardia, and premature ventricular contractions, also known as PVCs. The catheter ablation procedure is performed in the electrophysiology laboratory of the hospital, where you will be placed on an X-ray table. You may be given medications intravenously to sedate you or make you sleepy. These medications help reduce your anxiety and relieve your discomfort. Your groins will be cleaned with antiseptic and sterile drapes will be placed to cover your body. A local anesthetic will be administered with a tiny needle to numb the area where the catheters are inserted. You will feel a pinprick and possibly a stinging sensation for a few seconds. Small, thin wire electrodes will then be placed through a vein in the groin. These catheters will be guided to your heart using a special type of X-ray called fluoroscopy. Once in the heart, the electrodes measure the heart's electrical signals and are used to stimulate the heart from various locations to try to induce or start up the abnormal rhythm. Medications are sometimes used to assist in stimulating your arrhythmia. Special software is then used to make a 3D map of your heart and its electrical system to help your physician pinpoint the abnormal tissue in your heart. The catheters are then used to burn or freeze these small areas of heart tissue that generate and conduct the abnormal electrical activity. Upon the completion of the catheter ablation, the catheters are removed from your groin and pressure is applied to stop any bleeding. Following your catheter ablation, you will be moved to a recovery area to rest quietly for several hours. Your heartbeat and blood pressure will be monitored continuously to check for complications. Often, patients are able to go home the same day, but your physician may elect to keep you overnight for monitoring. Be sure to review pre- and post-documents on what to do before and after the procedure. As always, if you have questions, please reach out to your doctor's office. Thank you for choosing Norton Heart and Vascular Institute.